Hello guys, and welcome to a new StoDivision 2 video today by me, Vulcan. Today I have for you game 2 of a best of 5 between Prestigeon and Pixie in the 3rd place final in Season 3 of the StoDivision 2 League. Today they are playing on Ciano, and both players have once again decided to play on the Allied side. So this time around, Pixie is going to be using the 3rd Guards mechanized, and he's going to be using the flatline deployment type. He's over on the red side, and on the blue side we have Prestigeon using the 6th Airborne and the Vanguard deployment type. So an interesting matchup that I think falls in favor of the 3rd mechanized. The 3rd mechanized has decent infantry in the form of the Partisans early on. The Partisans do have Molotovs, which are quite nice for cleaning out close range, whilst also having rifles to hold things at medium range. He also has access to plenty of support weapons. He has the PTRSs. I'm not sure they get flamers, but definitely has MGs. And then also to back that all up, you've got Shermans at your back. And Shermans really do a number on the 6th Airborne. The reason for that is the 6th Airborne is going to be relying on mostly infantry and AT guns, and also things like Tetrarchs if we see them. But let's have a quick look at what's going down. So Pixie's got the PTRS on the top side there, followed by a Flamers. So he does have Flamers available. He's got the two Partisans, two Partisan DPs, and the M4. Further down, two more Flamers with the PTRS. It does have those units just zooming out in front. MG42 there with four Partisans following up and another Sherman. Further down, PTRS, three Flamers, multiple Partisan DP with an MG. So it looks like he's going for the range infantry engagement in the center of that town. Two Partisans, MG42, and another Sherman. So Sherman's for every road on the side of Pixie. On the side of Prestigeon, he's got Pathfinders on the very bottom side, probably sneak them around to the back of the map. Centaur's going to be covering the open ground with the flamethrowers there, and the snipers moving forwards are going to be multiple units of AB Paras, one of them being Canadian AB Paras and one of them Oxen Bucks in there. We've got two flamers and two snipers here with the AB Pack 75, that's the captured Pack 40 on the side of the 6th Airborne, and also the Tetrarch. The Tetrarch very weak at the moment to the Sherman, should that move forwards, but might be able to pick off some of these Partisans in the meantime. Two Canadian Paras moving into this town. Interesting that he's brought the 203 off map in on the top side. He's going to be hitting Pixie's side of the town further up, but nothing to really follow up on that. And he's also unloaded these units short on the top, the Canadian Paras, the AB Sniper, and the 6-Pounder. Well, let's pay attention to this engagement. MD42 and the Sherman on the ridge here, both able to engage the snipers, but a Typhoon, an early Typhoon. Very interesting to see. Only one available on the card in Phase A. Quite an expensive unit, 160 points. Looking for those quick early M4 kills, because he probably realizes that if he lets those build up, that could cause a big problem throughout the game. So off map comes down, two flamers are still alive, the other two infantry units falling back. The Centaur's doing okay in providing some infantry support onto these squads. Three of the Partisan DP have now died. At close range, those Partisan DP aren't very good against the flamethrowers. Once again, the Typhoon fails to get the rocket strike off. Loses line of sight, that's why it's not firing its rockets. Glider crew now coming in. Looks like Prestigeon might throw another off map down in here and then follow it up with the glider crew. Three Partisan DP, make that four Partisan DP on the way to back up that town. So that off map might land really well if he manages to catch out those fresh reinforcing troops as well. The AB Paras struggling to engage at range. One thing that the 6th Airborne does struggle with is ranged engagements in general, even in their infantry sometimes. Because these AB Paras, they have four submachine guns. So they don't really have the Lee Enfields to engage at range very well. But in engagements like this with the AB Canadian Paras, for example, they have the Willy P, they've got the five rifles and then four submachine guns. They actually do a decent amount of damage, but when you're engaging two, like, double machine gun squads, or in this case the 5 SVT and the DP at range, they're pretty much matching DPS with AB Paras, even though they're like half the size of squad. So in the end, the Typhoon just gonna leave 37 mil had time to come in, and Pixie's purchased a second one already. He does not want to have to deal with that typhoon throughout the game. Centaur does a good job of taking out the MG there. Going to open up some ground, but the Pathfinders being found in the open are now running further into the open whilst falling back. Is probably going to be a death sentence. Snipers moving around on the bottom side with the Pathfinders might eventually find their way to the spawn. And the off-map is coming down here, but it looks like Prester John may have been caught in his own off-map. It's really not good. These glider crew, they're not the best at close range. The SVTs will probably have more DPS than the Lee-Enfields here. Canadian Paras from range might be able to help kill off a few of them. But they are also better in close range with the 100 meters. And this just seems to be like a problem throughout the map. I guess here it's surprising that Prester John managed to get into the town as easily as he did, because there was the support of two M4s. However, I think these M4s just weren't really engaging all that time because of the Typhoon flying around. So inadvertently that Typhoon did allow him to get a foothold in the town, but once these start to build up with the support of AA, the Tetrarchs and Centaurs across the way are probably going to end up going down. And honestly, these AT guns don't particularly deal with Shermans too well from range unless they end up getting side shots. So it's probably going to bounce a few shots before anything goes through. Also, they've got to hit the mark first. So the pack there having a good go. Yeah, that's a bounce. Tetrarch did go down in the meantime. So more off-map landing. Tetrarchs now coming in to capitalize. Are up against the Sherman on this top side. So going to have to deal with it. There's also a Sherman covering from across the water here from the light cover. That's a really smart place for Pixie to put that M4 actually, because it allows it to help out with that objective further down. It looks like this M4 is really trying to go for the Centaur now. Centaur does have 85 mils of frontal armor, so that's not a large penetration chance for Pixie. It's probably like 15% or 20% for the 90 mils of penetration of the Sherman. Lag 3 is coming in with a strafing run though onto the Pack 40. Barely does a thing. Tempest nearly shoots down the lag in just a quick pass. That's going to get hit by the 37s, but I don't think it's really going to get suppressed that much. The nice thing about the Tempest is it is so damn fast, 680 kilometers per hour, and you can see the 37s, they're trying to track it, but just can't, and it's just outrunning all that AA. Nice play by Prester John, though. Capitalizing on his off-map, has managed to make the ground eventually, even though he did cause his gliders to fall back initially, one's all the way back here. On the bottom side, the Tetrarch Little John's pushing through. And what's interesting about the way that Prester John's using these units down here is he has the recon units. So Tetrarch Little John's a recon unit, technically, so they don't push the front line. So he's managing to sneak them through without having Pixie know about it. And Pixie right now probably see them in the open, but once they get out of the open, it's going to be very hard to see where those Tetrarchs are, and those Tetrarchs can be used to ambush all sorts of things, not just transport, but also tanks, because they have the 130 mils of penetration. The Typhoon did come in, but failed to get a strike onto the M4. It did land the rockets, but it just didn't get the kill. Centaur's still firing away onto the infantry from range. Looks like one of the Tetrarch Little John's going to get caught out by the M4 before it gets close. Limitation of these Tetrarch Little Johns is, of course, their penetration is only available at the 1,000 meter range. So, yeah, they get caught out at range by things like these M4s. And the M4s are starting to build up a little bit. You now have four on the bottom side and four Pixie, and then there's only the Centaurs on the side of Prester John. Prester John surprisingly has managed to keep a lot of this stuff at bay, but the concentration of forces for Pixie is much larger. Tempest coming in with a bombing run. The two 110 kilogram bombs forcing back the partisans, allowing the Canadian Paras an easy way to win that engagement. Prester John now pushing the 13 flags. Is very nice indeed. The 13 to 11. Getting our way into this game. Tetrarch Little John here, I presume, will be looking for an engagement with this Sherman at close range, but Pixie is going to see it coming. I think he's actually maybe going to move the Emcha in there. Potentially. The damage of the Little John is 5, so it would have to land 2 shots to get an M4 kill, whilst the M4 only has to shoot the Tetrarch once to kill it, or penetrate the Tetrarch once to kill it. And down here we've got the Canadian Leader going to land a Willy Pete onto the Partisans. That's going to do enough to help the glider crew to pin it down. I think the Centaur just killed the M4 with a HE round, since that got hit by the rockets of the Typhoon previously. Come on, Tetrarch, surely dead. Yep. Any matchup between Tetrarchs and Sherman's is always going to fall in the favor of Sherman's. I do see a little bit of an opportunity here for Prester John, though, to push onto the Salient. Let's tell him that there's not much there, and even just a single glider crew starting to move across should be able to make enough ground to push the Salient. This is one area of the map that I don't see players reinforce very often, you know, even with one infantry squad to just stop that from being captured. Looks like this time around Pixie's going to get that covered. Pathfinders, they're having a go at the Partisan MG. They do have rifles on target. Tetrarch Little John's going to reveal its position by firing at the Gavardia. Partisan MG goes down. Gavardia DPR trying to chase onto those. Tempest coming in for the bombing strike onto the Gavardia DP. The Oxenbucks not even going to have to do a thing. Now the Tetrarch Little John looking to help out. Going for the shot onto the M4, and as I mentioned, Tetrarch takes a shot. He did penetrate, but he didn't kill, whilst the M4 easily kills the Tetrarch in one shot. So at that range, accuracy is pretty damn high, hard to miss, and you're just going to trade like that every time. And if the M4's already been weakened or hit, like that one now has, the next Tetrarch that comes along might get the kill if it fires first. You saw they roughly fired at the same time, so it's probably going to be 2 Tetrarchs for every Sherman, and that's not really good value, especially in terms of the recon Tetrarchs. Might work out better for normal Tetrarchs because they're only 25 points apiece, but they don't have the penetration that the Little Johns have, so you're kind of in trouble there. So it looks like Prester John hit himself with off map again. Definitely no off-map on the side of Pixie, so yeah, that must have been his own. Centaur here actually out of ammunition. Currently under fire from both of the M4s. Yeah, there must be like 10% penetration chance, something like that. That's why they're bouncing and just not killing at all. Well, that one penetrated as soon as I said that. Classic caster curse. Typhoon coming in. Oh, lovely kill from the 17-pounder there. Bailed out the M4, gonna get the kill with that shot. Typhoon doesn't even have a target anymore. Tempest gonna be coming in, finish off the Gavardia DP, and this is one way that Prester John can get into the game. I still feel like the Shermans have the pressure, and they're still building up, regardless of a couple kills here and there. That's like 1 kill, 2 kills on the Shermans so far, but you've got 2 Valentines on the way. There's now 4 Shermans on the top side of the map. This Tempest going to go for the lag, shoot that down. So that's going to continue air in the favor of Prester John. Okay, looks like the lag survived for now. Did get the kill onto the 17-pounder. That's pretty important. Typhoon comes through, does kill the Sherman in the Light Forest. A good kill from Pixie taking out the 17-pounder. Those 17-pounders are going to be the primary threat for his tanks, aside from those Typhoon ATs. And so if he can shut down both of those, then he's on to a winner. But for now, Prester John's in the lead, 13-11. We can't ignore that. He still controls the town, because he's going to have to try and take it back sooner than later. And on the bottom side, these Centaurs have been managing to keep the infantry of Pixie at bay. And another Pathfinder unit makes its way through the bottom side of the map. Now that could probably end up killing this Sys 3 if it finds it. Certainly has the recon capability to do so. two Canadian paras and another 17 pounder on its way. Going to be replacing that immediately. This is a good way to catch out an opponent sometimes. They are convinced that they've killed the 17 pounder. They saw it die. But, you know, if you put another 17 pounder exactly where it was before, then you can catch out a tank in the future because they don't inherently believe that it's still there. The lag coming in on the top side for a bombing run onto the 6 pounder. Tempest going to be trying to catch the lag. Might be able to do so. Right, Prester John's pulled that away to do a bombing strike. 6 pounder did survive those bombs this time around. So the two Canadian paras on the way. Valentine's looking for the transport snipe. I think the reason that Pixie's brought in these Valentines is to deal with the Centaurs mainly, because they have that bit extra penetration. Almost hits the paras though. Both the paras going down on the bottom side before they unload. That is unfortunate for Prester John. Slag, I'm surprised it's still in the sky. There's no AA on this top side. That's very risky business. Mosquito coming in with the bombing strike. Kills off the Gavardia. Pixie actually stopped his tankos to avoid them being bombed. Now the lag coming around, trying to go for a jot onto the Mosquito. The Mosquito going straight up into the sky. Tempest takes out the lag. Will the Mosquito get away? Just climbing and climbing and climbing. Looks like it might. It's just gone straight out of range of the M17 by just going straight up. B39 comes in to try and take out one of the Tempests, but doesn't manage to do so. The Prester John maintaining that lead. Now the Tanko Dasaniki, though, coming in. Looks like this is a Phase B unit. Of course, Pixie's running the flatline. So, bringing in loads of Tankos now to engage at close range. Partisans in the early game. Tankos in the mid game. It's going to work out potentially quite well. But the P39 going for these engagements onto the Tempest. The M17 might be able to help quite a bit here, because it's going to stop that Tempest from getting on his tail. It's all about the head-on, and the Cobra has a better gun for head-on. It's got the 37, so it does more damage, and it manages to take out the Tempest. Nicely done. But yeah, considering the income values once again, Vanguard is very strong in the early game, and Prester John has managed to take an advantage, but is it enough of an advantage? That is the question, because from now on, Prester John's going to be at a disadvantage in income. And therefore, Pixie, especially in Phase C, can get quite a lot of work done with the extra 20 points per minute. That's going to be an extra infantry squad per minute, which over time certainly adds up. On the bottom side, both of the Valentines died. The 17-pounder took out one and then the other, I believe. Actually, no, that one's still alive. He took out the one further up. This 17-pounder is going to engage the Sherman now, though. Pixie paying attention to that? He might be busy microing his Tankos on the top side. It looks like he did pull it back, though. Tankos moving forwards here. AB Parra's not going to last long in the face of the Tanko Dasaniki. The Parra's, they don't have a Willy Pete like the Canadian Parra's do. And that really doesn't help them against units like this. The Tanko's running them down so fast with the triple Molotov landing. I think he purposefully held one of the Tankos back to maintain the Molotovs for future engagements. The two Gavardia that were brought in to stop the salient on the hill have actually found their way to the glider crew. Typhoon AT comes in, takes out another Sherman down here. I believe these 37s should probably be moved up a bit more. They seem a bit too far back. Especially if this Tempest, for example, can bomb these Gavardia without taking really any shots at all. That's not too good. Tanko Dasaniki, though, coming into the town, now neutralizing the lead that Prester John had. Those Tankos with the Molotov, they're going to rip up those glider crew very quickly indeed. Goodbye to those. AB Parra's doing a runner. Means that Prester John might not take back that town anytime soon. That Canadian Parra only has one man remaining. So severe lack of infantry here for Prester John to support his hold on that town. Typhoon coming in for the rocket strike. Doesn't take out the M4 this time around. Flies straight over the M17. A little bit risky, but should get away. Centaur again. Centaurs have just done so much work. One of them has died on the bottom side. 17 pounder, however, taking out another Valentine. And looks like the 17 pounder being pushed back to the same position as the previous one, or at least close to, has worked out quite well. So back to equal. Partisans will be able to get on top of the AB Paras with a Molotov. That's going to be a hard engagement for the AB Paras there. Mosquito coming in for the bombing run. Certainly going to do plenty of damage. He's letting that land before pushing forwards with the Canadian Paras. They're going to be trading Molotov and Willy P. AB Engineers following that up will be able to land a TNT on them, which will probably kill off a Tanko Destoniki squad quite easily. But more AB Paras coming in to contest this town. Off map now on the side of Pixie, though. Has already landed once and done a decent amount of damage. Might also end up clipping these AB Paras and allowing Pixie to move back in the opposite direction. Nice bombing strike from the Tempest does allow him to pin down more of the Tanko Destoniki in those trees, removing the foothold that Pixie had up there. So nicely done. I guess his Bedford supply could be moved to the other Centaur to fill it up in the meantime. Partisans do take out the AB Paras. It looks like the foothold that Prester John had up here is going to fall the opposite direction now. Pixie kind of mounting up a bunch of infantry in a counterattack has actually led to him having a massive advantage in infantry in this area. And now that the off-map's coming down, these AB Paras will be pinned and there's going to be nothing in his way. Pixie can just move straight into this town and take it. Mosquito coming into the bombing for the bombing strike. Does manage to pin down a couple of the Gavardia, but the Tanko Destoniki here still absolutely fine. Just going to be charging straight into his own off map. Should end soon though. 37 still a little bit too far back for my liking. Gavardia now coming in on the bottom side. The backup, the lone Sherman down there. Could be potential for a push. But the fact these Centaurs have been doing so much work throughout the game has really, really helped Prester John out. Without those Centaurs, I feel like the Shermans would have just had almost infinite fire support over any infantry movement. Of course, the 17 pounders definitely helped out a lot. But there is a limited amount of these 17 pounders. And if Pixie starts picking them off one by one, eventually, it's going to get to the point where Pixie can overrun them with a majority of Shermans. IL-4 coming in with the 1,000 kilogram bomb. Almost annihilates that AB Para in one hit. Didn't even land on target, so you can see how effective that has the potential to be. Tempest looking for the chase, but going to end up over the top of the 37. And the M17, but the M17 is actually out of ammunition. I think Pixie's just playing it safe there with the IL-4. Putting it into a turn so that it can't be chased off and killed down. Smart move. Typhoon with the rockets coming in again. Maybe looking for the last Sherman on this bottom side of the map. Could also try for the Shermans into the town here. This 37 would be blocked line of sight onto a Typhoon that came in from the bottom right. There's potential there. It looks like Pixie, after his off-map strikes, did manage to get the tankers quite far up. But Prester John has managed to get into the town here with some AB Paras to defend. There's a couple more on the way. That truck following it up. Typhoon's now coming in for that rocket strike. And as I mentioned, AA is going to be firing way too late to be helpful. No kill, though, onto the Sherman. So, yeah. It's a shame those Typhoons are being unreliable for Prester John, because that could give him a bit more breathing space in this game. Unfortunately, though, not the case, and he's going to have to deal with each and every one, and I'm pretty sure Pixie has them up his sleeve, like a lot of them up his sleeve. for the rest of the game. 37 now being brought in, though. Support the ones in the town. After a typhoon hits the Sherman, it might be worth Prestige on like using a bomber to try and finish it off. It'll probably be a good way to deal with things, because often a typhoon strike that doesn't kill a tank will leave it on low health, and you can see that by the fact that the unit looks more rusted and damaged. Kind of indicates health, even though you don't have a health bar. The Little John, will it be able to kill off the Sherman? Sherman gets the first shot off. Little John goes down. Not good news, because now the Shermans are pretty much free to help the engagement against these paras, as long as they don't move into line of sight of the 17-pounder. Typhoon coming in with a rocket strike, not going to be answered. Mosquito was the one to be pinned and didn't manage to drop its bombs. That could go down. These 2 and 3 star 37s are reasonably accurate, especially when they start flying in a straight line. Only needs a couple more hits. Not going to be a kill today. Mosquito landing a lovely bombing strike there to take out one of the Gvardia squads. I am a tad worried about the lack of reinforcements coming in on the field from Prester John. He's looking very light on the ground, whilst Pixie, well, as you can see, is bringing in waves upon waves of infantry every time. Whereas this time around, Prester John's, you know, purchased a bomber and a couple of AB paras. So it looks like Prester John's being forced to rely a lot on those aircraft, and it is kind of working out. But with the 37s coming into play and the ones on the bottom side moving forward slightly, that is going to cause more of his units to take damage or be shot down. And even if they take damage, you know, they're going to be taking longer to come back again and be ready to go. So that's quite important. 17-pounder almost snipes another transport. It looks like Pixie here trying to make sure they unload before they get killed. But I'm not sure if Prester John's purposefully targeting the one that's behind the front one, or if that's just the AI doing that. But that was just funny, because Pixie was like unloading the one at the front, expecting it to be the one that gets shot, and then the one behind it was the one being targeted by the 17-pounder. So yeah, that was, I don't know, it's that mind games from Prester John. It'd be smart if it was, but I think it might have just been the AI. Double Mosquito, or a triple Mosquito, on its way. One of them's hanging back. Two of them have targets. It looks like the Tempest going in for the bombing strike onto the 37. And then the Mosquito's coming in to finish it off. He's really just hammering into this AA right now. He doesn't like it. He wants to get rid of it for good. Well, this Mosquito, though. Oh, that's so damn close to the M17. That was flying so low to the ground. The M17 just chewed it up, and the Cobra's going to take out a second Mosquito, and that Mosquito's coming in, gets the weapon jammer to the IL-4 that's going to stop it dropping its bomb. But is that going to go down as well? Oh no! The Cobra gets called back. I feel like it might have been worth losing the Cobra to get a third Mosquito there, because that was serious damage done to Prester John's aircraft. That's the risk you take diving into AA like that, is if it goes wrong and your opponent has a fighter to clean up, then you're left in exactly that position. And Prester John here, he's put an attack beacon on that 37 so he can mark exactly where it is. That's probably for either artillery in the future, or maybe he's lining up an airstrike. It's probably more likely an airstrike. Centaur once again getting some free shots onto infantry. Been there the whole game so far. AB paras grouping up to push into the town, but there are a lot of Gvardia in the way. At range, these Gvardia, they eat AB paras, because the AB paras, 5 Lee Enfields, Bren, machine gun. Gvardia, they've got 8 Mosins and the DP. Bottom side, Germans just bouncing off the Centaur all day long. Typhoon's going to be coming in for the strike. Let's see if the 37s can hit this hard enough. Well, Typhoon 80 does its job. And out he goes. 37s, yeah, weren't shooting fast enough. Either way, AB Paras go down in the open. Looks like the Gavardia, the 2v3 did actually fall in favor of Prester John here. Probably most likely due to veterancy. These AB Paras, though, not in cover, whilst the Gavardia are certainly falling in favor of Pixie. Until the bombers come in, of course. Here come the Tempests with those 110 kilogram bombs. Plenty of damage. No time for the AA to react. Super fast. Now the IR-4, though, coming in. And that is a bombing strike. I'm surprised he's dropping the 1,000 kilogram bomb in the same place that he's dropping the off-map. But it does have a rather large area to pin. The Tempest, well, that stayed in the sky. It took out the IL-4. Is now going for the Cobra as well, potentially, but gets weapon jammed by the AA. The Tempest is going to have to go home. So yeah, I think Pixie just definitely needs to cancel this off-map now and just place it somewhere else. Seems like a waste to have it land there in the town. Mosquito coming in for the bombing strike. Now that really didn't hit the mark at all, did it? And then got shot down instantly. Oh, it crashed straight into the off-map vehicle. That's beautiful. I think this off-map vehicle was used up, but that is beautiful. Pixie writes GG. The suicide Mosquito into the off-map. Maybe it wasn't used up. But that is awesome stuff. Awesome stuff to see indeed. Very nice. Alright, 17 pounder finding shots here onto one of the M4s. M4 briefly getting into cover. Off map did end up hitting these AB Paras quite nicely. The two healthy AB Paras ended up walking into the off map. Whilst Pixie's Gavardia sort of fell back and died to the ranged engagements. So back to 12 to 12 again. Things not really going anywhere. IL-4 coming in with that bomb. Have a look at this. Taking a lot of damage from the Tripolston. But bombs away. They're going to go down to the Tripolston. Tempest surely going to catch it in time. Kills the 17 pounder with the IL-4. Tempests are distracted by the Cobra, and it looks like the AA's done enough to force back the first Tempest. Will they shoot down the second? Yes, the Tempest goes down. Lovely kill there for Pixie. Those Tempests are great when you manage to get them out of the sky, because it opens up so many opportunities for your own airstrikes, but also your ability to chase down things like this Mosquito. Bombing strike does plenty of damage to the Gavardia DP there. Pulls away from the AA on the top side, so will likely survive because of that. These AB Para really struggling at range. And more Gavardia on the way for Pixie. The flatline deployment type, I think, is really going to pay off here for Pixie in the long run. Because he will have likely built his division to have more infantry availability than Prester John. And Prester John's so reliant on these aircraft to do damage. And with them starting to get shot down, it really doesn't help much at all. Good hits though onto the Gavardia. There's two more Gavardia going to die because of those strikes. And the Typhoon's also going to get a strike onto the Sherman. No kill though. Bottom side hasn't really moved much. I think the Centaur, yeah, the Centaur moved up to the mid. So there is potential now for an infantry play on this bottom side. Gavardia starting to move forwards. Triple Tenko Dasaniki prepping for a push now into the town. The 17 pounder would have to kill those half tracks, otherwise it's not gonna make it there at all. Well, otherwise they are gonna make it there, sorry, and the tankos will take that flag very easily. Mosquito finds a nice bombing strike there. I think the reason that Prestigeon did this with all of his aircraft was to sort of lead the way for the Mosquito. So he caused Pixie's AA to shoot at his Tempest whilst the Mosquito got a clean bombing strike. That's pretty smart to do. The only trouble is if his Tempest take more damage, they're going to take longer to reload. So that's not something I think he can really, I guess, rely on at the moment, because he needs his units to reload as quickly as possible in order to counter the infantry availability that Pixie has. So the Typhoon there, getting a good strike, kills another Sherman. Cutting down on the Shermans, it's been important all game, and he's done a pretty good job of it so far. 17 pounder coming in to replace the one he lost to the IL-4 previously. Now going to be able to kill off the two Shermans up there. Yeah, nothing's going to stop these tankos from getting into position, and that one flamer is going to go down very quickly. This one flamer will also die, and that's going to be another flag taken for Pixie. So this looks like a 14 to 10 in the making. Then if any infantry gets further across, well, 17 pounder is not going to be able to do much. Looks like the Centaur moved up to the top side. It died because of it. Challenger now on the way to engage on the bottom side. Now, Challenger's quite useful for engaging the Shermans at range because it has pretty oversized gun for dealing with them. But currently with the infantry push, that's a big salient. 16 to 8 just from that. Nicely done. But I think it purely comes down to the fact that honestly, Prestigeon doesn't have much more to reinforce with, and whilst Pixie just pulling more troops out of him. Just more and more coming out of this deck, and I think Prestigeon realizes it. He's just out of troops, and 35 minutes, 57 seconds, Prestigeon's going to surrender, and I think that was quite a respectful surrender, honestly, because he definitely could have dragged the game out and let the timer run down, but if he's out of infantry at that point, there's not really much chance of him coming back. So there we have it. Pixie actually winning with a negative KD, 2,890 kills to 3,160 losses, but had more availability in this deck, so had more on the field at the end, and that's pretty much what led to the victory. Nicely done with the infantry, I feel. I guess the Shermans here, you can see that they're cleaning up the infantry quite easily, and they're also cleaning up the Tetrarchs. So there's basically nothing that Prestigeon can do to kill these M4s other than AT guns and aircraft. And so if he manages to counter both of those, which he kind of managed to during the game, he brought in AA very early on, two AA to cover his tanks on the bottom side, although I wasn't a fan of the placement of the AA. And he brought in plenty of AA eventually on the top side as well. So that counters aircraft eventually. And you can see that some of these 37s were eventually killing the Mosquitoes. Tempests are always going to be very hard to shoot down. You need a kind of an overwhelming amount of AA to really counter those, so it's not always worth it. And the AT guns, well, at close range, the Shermans can deal with them himself with those, but the IL-4s coming in here, picking off a few 17-pounders. And as I mentioned at the start, the availability of 17-pounders is actually quite limited. Well, I don't think I mentioned at the start, but maybe like midway through, I was talking about how Prestigeon, he's only going to have like seven... also 17 pounders. I don't know exactly the availability numbers on that, but yeah, it's around that number. Once he runs out, that's it. And the Shermans have pretty much infinite pushing power against the Sixth at that point. Typhoon did its best, took out four Shermans there. Nicely done. This 17 pounder also took out another four. It's just way too many. It's way too many in the long run. These Centaurs were really, really nice. That one actually killing the M4 there. So, good game. I feel like Prestigeon was just a disadvantage from the start. Again, a similar fate to the first game, really. In the first game, the group of Viborg just running over the 2nd Infantry. I think Prester John's maybe got too comfortable with the Western Front divisions, and the Soviet divisions of Pixie are able to get the better of him. I think Pixie's used two divisions that aren't necessarily meta. I don't think Group of Viborg was a tool. Third mech is more meta, I guess, than most, but probably not as meta as some of the other available divisions. So, yeah, good job by Pixie. Takes the 2nd game of this best of 5. Only needs to win one more. Prester John's going to have to win the next game in order to stay in the series. But that is it for now. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.